problem solving is a day-to-day feature of industrial hygiene.
It's a whole wellness, mental, physical, everything comes together when you look at body mechanics.
The excitement is I get to impact somebody's life almost every day of the year.
To ensure real-world impact in industrial hygiene and occupational safety requires a mixture of both science and application. Linking these two things is an important area of focus for the University of Cincinnati's Education and Research Center. Doing this through a multidisciplinary approach that brings together research, faculty, students, and experienced professionals.
A sense of pride and excitement bubbles up whenever researchers at the University of Cincinnati discuss the benefits of industrial hygiene and occupational safety careers.
It's dynamic. I think it has real-world impact. I mean, how many other professions do you have that you can actually help people before they get hurt or injured?
That same spirit lives in the graduates of the program, too, who see their work as more recognized than ever before.
But now when I say, oh, I have a PhD in occupational safety and ergonomics, oh, wow, they know exactly what I'm referring to.
To advance the profession of workplace safety, an interdisciplinary approach is a key constant.
It's not just about the simple safety person or industrial hygienist. You're going to need to bring in an interdisciplinary team to really fix some of the health hazards that are out there.
Understanding the hazards and emerging exposures requires a broad academic education combined with new evaluation tools.
Where you can really find out why these exposures might be driving the risk, and then we'll simulate in laboratories and use very quantitative type of measures to assess the exposures, whether that's aerosols, ergonomics.
Home health care is a growing area where research is impacting workplace safety.
So as you know, home health care is in the media, it's a brand new term, but the world is in need of health care. However, the future of healthcare is home healthcare.
With more and more people receiving care at home, the focus is on the safety of the caregivers and the unique exposures they face.
Every home is a different workplace. And some of them could have bad aerosols. With molds, you have things like pets running around. You have issues with pests, bed bugs, cockroaches.
With dynamic and constantly changing factors, these workspaces need collaboration and input from all areas of safety research.
I do biological hazards, so I'm looking at biological particles in the air, how these particles are suspended in the air, resuspended, and how they're generated.
Then you have the ergonomic issues that you end up not having helpers to help you move a patient. You don't have any lifts, you don't have any safe patient handling equipment, so you're doing everything by themselves.
When I really stepped back and did the research and noticed how much lifting they were doing, how their body mechanics were affected, I believe that kind of highlighted an area that we really need to focus more on. So now we're hearing more about lift assist equipment, right? Lifting teams within the nursing industry.
Research in a post-pandemic world, driving new insights and safety standards.
But our research in respirators, I think, has been in spotlights like never before.
Measuring filter efficiency, fit factors, materials, and sharing the data with NIOSH to help develop these new standards.
Which impacted the way that they test respirators, and this knowledge actually was also shared with new industry, with small companies and large companies that helped them develop a new generation of respirators.
Sharing these developments and ever-evolving research with professionals working in the field.
So professionals can come back and learn about these new hazards, new techniques.
It's never ending. The connection is not come, graduate, turn and walk away. The door is always open to come back and further research and keep the learning going and making sure that this industry grows in knowledge, for sure.
And preparing the next generation of safety experts through blending classwork, lab techniques, and real-world experience.
Many students say that that's the best part of the education has been these interdisciplinary trips.
Preparation for a career that has immediate needs.
And the great thing is our program has basically 100% placement, getting a job before they graduate.
We don't have enough occupational health professionals. Actually, there's a need of occupational health professionals in the world, whether you're in private industry, whether you're in research.
Companies are spending money because they know the investment is worth it. If you invest in the health and safety of your employees, you have a better employee that's gonna stay longer, gonna perform better, and make more money for the company.
Inspiring, informing, and educating the next generation to help create healthier workplaces.
The whole point of industrial hygiene and occupational ergonomics and the excitement of that is that you can have impact in almost any type. I mean, it can be leisure activities, it could be on the job, it could be anywhere that you have exposures that could impact your life in the long term.